Akali Phula Singh. When Guru Gobind Singh left his body, his soul merged with God as a light merges with light. Before leaving the earth, he gave the Khalsa his strength, his courage, and the hope for the future. He told the Sikhs, "Remember, O my beloved Khalsa, I live within every Khalsa. The Khalsa is my very soul. The Khalsa is my very breath." The Sikhs asked, "O Guruji, O true king, who will lead us? Who will be our guru when you leave? Your sons are all dead. There is no one who is wise enough or brave enough to become the guru. What will we do? Who will be our guru?" Then Guru Gobind Singh, with fire in his words and love in his heart, said to them, "For all times to come, the Sri Guru Granth Sahib shall be your guru. When you want to see me, come and bow to the Sri Guru Granth Sahib. When you want to hear me talk to you, listen to the words of the Sri Guru Granth Sahib. When you want to speak with me, come and read from the Sri Guru Granth Sahib. The Sri Guru Granth Sahib is not a book. It is the word of God. It is exactly the same as me." For a long time, the Sikhs stayed united, defending themselves when they were attacked. But later, some forgot what Guru Gobind Singh had taught them. Some did not. There was a great Sikh warrior named Akali Phula Singh. He was a pure Khalsa who constantly chanted God's name and who lived as Guru Gobind Singh told us to live. There was no fear or hatred in his heart. He arose early every morning to do his sadhana, and he treated all men alike. Unfortunately, many Sikhs had become greedy. Brothers of the Khalsa were fighting among themselves. Imagine one Khalsa army fighting another Khalsa army. Khalsa killing Khalsa. Uncles fighting their nephews. Friends killing friends. These Sikhs all wanted to have their own armies. And they also wanted to control many villages, have power and money. One day, two Khalsa armies were even about to fight in Amritsar to decide who would control Amritsar and the Golden Temple. This was a very sad day for the Khalsa. When Akali Phula Singh heard this, his heart ached and it made him very sad. He thought of Guru Gobind Singh, who lived in every Khalsa, and went to see the generals of both armies. Then he said to them, "Wahe Guru Ji ka Khalsa, Wahe Guru Ji ki Fateh." "Look," he said, "we are all Khalsa. We are all brothers. We must not fight with one another. Guru Gobind Singh is our father. We must stand united." Thank you. Sikh generals were convinced by the words of Akali Phula Singh and agreed not to fight. Akali Phula Singh honestly and bravely served the Khalsa for a long time. Many years later, the king of the Sikhs, Maharaja Ranjit Singh, went to war against the Afghan armies. Akali Phula Singh was one of his best generals. He was the leader of the Akalis, the most fearless soldiers of the Khalsa army. It was the night before the battle. The king and his generals did not go to sleep that night. Instead, they made plans for the battle that they would fight tomorrow. Their army is very strong. This is it then. We'll attack early tomorrow morning. Let us go say Ardas and take a hukam from Sri Guru Granth Sahib. The king, Akali Phula Singh, and the other generals then went to the Gurdwara, which had been set up in a tent. They prayed together. O true king, O loved father, give us victory tomorrow. May we be brave and fight with the Guru in our hearts. We depend on you. Our life is in your hands. We are the Khalsa. We belong to you. And victory belongs to you. Then they listened to the hukam.
Satnam Sri Wahe Guru. Slok Mahala Panyuma Tera Kita Jato Nahi Mano Jog Kitoi Man Nirgun Yare Ko Gun Nahi Aape Tars Payoi.
After the hukam was read, all went to get ready for the great battle. But then, one of the king's spies, who had been watching the enemy throughout the night, came running into the camp.
Sire! Sire!
Yes? The enemy has many big guns.
Oh.
They arrived during the night. This will change our plans, said the king. He called his generals together, and then they all agreed.
Our big guns will arrive at noon. Let us wait until they arrive. Then we'll attack.
They all agreed, except one, Akali Phula Singh.
No,
he said. We prayed before Guru Granth Sahib. We must attack now. We are the Khalsa. We place our lives in the Guru's hands, not in the strength of cannon.
But Khalsa ji, we cannot charge against their cannon.
Yes. A Khalsa with God in his heart is fearless, and nothing is impossible for him. I will not go back on my word.
Akali Phula Singh quickly walked outside. He jumped on his horse and galloped over to where his Akali soldiers were waiting.
He then drew his long, sharp sword and said, "For the honor of the house of Guru, victory be to God. Today we fight to the death. Let us show the world the courage of the army of Guru Gobind Singh and all the Khalsa warriors, like one man, drew their swords and called out, Then they trotted their horses to the front of the enemy army. Akali Phula Singh, standing in his stirrups, yelled out,
"Sat Sri Akal!"
They answered him, "Charge!" Akali spurred his powerful battle horse, raised his sword and galloped towards the enemy like a bolt of lightning. The Khalsa soldiers followed him, racing with each other towards the enemy. Unexpected charge.
"Oh God, what is he doing?"
"He's charging with the Akali, sire.
We were supposed to wait."
"Sant Akali could not wait, G. He said we promised Guru to fight at dawn." The king thought for a moment.
"All right," said the king. "Sound the attack. We'll charge with them."
Everywhere, the sound was heard. And the king's entire army attacked the enemy. Akali Phula Singh was still the first man in the charge. The bullets were flying. Many Sikh soldiers had been killed. Many were wounded. But still, Akali Phula Singh urged them on, cutting through the enemy. Nothing could stop him. Several bullets had hit him, swords had cut him. But he kept on driving on to crush the enemy. Another bullet hit him. And he fell from his horse, mortally wounded. Some of his men jumped down from their horses and came to help him. But Babaji, with his last ounce of strength, told them, "Charge! Fight for the Khalsa! Onward! Sat Sri Akal!" And with his last breath, he urged the Khalsa army onward. "Fight! Fight for Guru Gobind Singh!" The Sikh soldiers completely defeated the enemy. Many felt sad that Akali Phula Singh had died, but all knew that he had died doing his duty, fearlessly and faithfully.
As the Siddhi Singh Sahib has many times told us, don't give an inch. Keep up. Akali Phula Singh, who lived the life of a soldier, never gave an inch. His word and his love of God and Guru were dearer to him than his very life. If you keep up, God will keep you up. Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh.